Welcome to Blended and Flipped Learning using the 5E's Inquiry Model in Microsoft Teams. My name is Tiffany Thompson and I'm going to be your presenter for today's session. I am a Microsoft Learning Consultant in the DC, Virginia region. I am also an experienced educator who uses Blended and Flipped Learning when teaching myself. The 5E's Inquiry Model of designing learning activities has made it much simpler for me to organize and craft learning activities, particularly in Teams. Today, I'm going to show you and help you understand the difference between blended and flipped learning and how to use these teaching approaches along with the 5E's in your class team. The power of blended learning methods lies in their ability to improve the student experience. Studies have shown that blended learning reduces failure rates, improves learning, and boosts engagement. Blended learning combines the best aspects of face-to-face and online instruction in ways that enable students to learn at their own pace. For example, a student in a blended learning course who masters a concept earlier than his peers can move on without having to wait. And conversely, a student who needs more time is not forced to move forward before fully grasping the subject. It is proving to be a scalable learning model that simply works for diverse populations of students, which, as we can see today, is indicative of many classrooms. The roles in a flipped class are what differentiate this approach from other models. In a flipped classroom, teachers serve more as facilitators rather than traditional instructors lecturing to students. Educators act as guides, structuring class time and clearing up confusion with the material. We are there simply as a resource to help students master the concepts in class and should be on the lookout for any students that appear to be struggling or failing behind. In a flipped classroom, students take a much more active role in the flipped classroom model than in a traditional model. Students develop a familiarity with the material via videos or other instructional materials that are made available outside of the classroom or in their digital learning environment. This pre-work, so to speak, allows them to control their learning more, interact more with other students, and set the pace for discussions during live class sessions. The intent here is for students to see the material beforehand, which is also commonly called first exposure learning, so they can learn the concepts at their own pace. And by doing so, the students are able to focus more on those engaging hands-on activities. What is the difference between blended versus flipped? Well, both use online and face-to-face teaching to provide a comprehensive learning experience. However, the major difference is when and how the online learning takes place. In the flipped classroom, students must watch the e-learning video or participate in another online exercise before coming to class. And then in the live class, the new material is further explained or explored at length. In most cases, that knowledge is then applied in the live class as well. But in blended classrooms, students aren't getting that total first exposure. They may get a bite-sized intro to prep them for the live class where the teacher will be providing most of the instruction. Teams is an ideal tool for building out a flipped or blended classroom as it is customizable to fit your students' needs and allows you to use many apps for engaging, exploring, explaining, elaborating, and evaluating, which are the 5 E's of learning through inquiry. The 5E's lesson plan supports inquiry-based instruction. It is typically used in science, but I use it in many subjects, as it allows children to make discoveries and to process new skills in an engaging way, which is key when blending or flipping your classroom. Children are not just learning with this method, they are more knowledgeable about their own metacognition, and the role of the teacher is to facilitate and support students as they use prior knowledge to build new knowledge. When I set up my lessons for the week using the 5E's model, I use the announcement feature in conversations to call attention to the day's activities. For the engage phase, I am providing students with learning materials they need to be introduced to main idea. In this lesson about main idea, I posted a short YouTube video for the students to watch. I can paste the link directly from YouTube or search for the video using the YouTube extension in the conversation editor. Next is explore. Again, I create an announcement and title it appropriately. For this part of the lesson, I'm going to use a Nearpod activity about main idea for the students to practice identifying the main idea in a paragraph. You can paste the link directly into the conversation editor, and alternatively, you can add it as a tab at the top of a channel. You would simply select Nearpod, log in with your username and password, select the activity from your Nearpod library, and save. Students will be able to access the activity from directly within Teams. As you can see here, I offered students both options for engaging in the Nearpod activity for the exploration phase. You can also use forms or vocabulary. You can create a OneNote assignment or even use ThingLink or math in OneNote. The options here are endless. Explain is typically reserved for the face-to-face instructional activities with the teacher. This is the time for you to clarify misunderstandings, reteach, or guide students into a deeper understanding of the topic. In Teams, I like to keep my lesson organized, so I still include a heading for explain. I work with students of all levels and have found it really useful to provide direction for accessing the live class meeting. Sometimes I will add an image, such as an arrow or a down arrow, or something to help them to remember where to click. This will help them to get access directly to the meeting link that I'll schedule below. Now that I've scheduled my live class meeting, I can click on the link to join it. And in my live Teams meeting, I can present using a blank OneNote page, a PowerPoint slide, or even a whiteboard built directly into Teams. I can also create a collaborative whiteboard session for students to join as well. Again, the options are endless. During the elaborate phase, I can work with small groups who are still struggling with the concept of main idea. In this team, I've created small groups and private channels. I can post additional videos, hands-on activities, or even schedule team meetings for these small groups. I typically will provide instruction in the same format in which I provided the engage, explore, explain instructions so that students will know to get into their small groups or go to that private channel to engage in additional learning activities. In this case, students will play a Kahoot game that I will include. During the evaluation stage, you are assessing students' knowledge of the skills or topic taught. You can do this using many tools or apps. In my lesson, I'm creating a OneNote assignment for my students. I added a main idea worksheet to the content library, and now I'm attaching it as a resource to the team's assignment. After adding it as a resource, you can select the due date, the time that it is due. You can add points to determine how much the assignment is worth. You can also decide to add it to all of your students' accounts or to only a select group of students. And then you can also use tools such as Turnitin to check for originality. Using Teams assignments is a great way to assess your students, whether you're assessing them formatively or summatively. Now you've learned about 5 E's, flipped and blended learning, let's talk about some Teams best practices. Communication. Use general channel for announcements as to not interrupt the flow of the weekly lessons. Set channel permissions for moderation so that students aren't able to make posts between your 5 E's posts. Though, I would definitely allow them to reply so that they can ask questions or you can create meaningful discussions around topics. Try to format your conversations as announcements, as I did. My students have become very accustomed to seeing the 5 E's headings. Alternatively, you could use days of the week as headings for your post, knowing that Monday would be engage, Tuesday explore, and so on. During the explain phase, when you're using Teams meetings for whole class lessons, remember to set norms and utilize mute as well as meeting options. For student engagement and management, remember organization is key. Try to order and teach your students to pin channels so that they're easily accessible. Also, create student helpers and manage those helpers with tags. Use praise to reward positive online behavior and teach your students how to use help for problem solving skills. Remember, Teams is purposely built for education and customized for the way schools collaborate, teachers teach, and students learn. Create blended and flipped learning classrooms that will save you time and better engage your students in modern learning. Thank you for joining me today. Please redeem your achievement code for participating in today's session at education.microsoft.com. Thank you.